It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some ARK Survival Evolved. Hope you guys are having a good day. Terry's having a great day, and we're back doing some stuff and things, peeps. You know, I got a dead body over here. I don't even know how that happened. What do we got? We got this guy right here. So I wanted to show you guys. I made a little bit of narcotics, trying to get some level up action happening. So, and I got it. We're at level 70 now, and I wanted to get this really bad because we need this in order to play around with buildable saddles. Tiny, give me your meat. So, anyhoozle, up here, doing stuff and things. We're going to be doing the buildable Bronto saddles today, peeps. We're going to throw some of this over here. I made some preserving bids down in the town. Let's just say, been doing a lot of cooking over there, and a lot of times when I log in, there's not a lot of meat over there. And so I decided to set up some of my own special meat, so I have some food when I get on the server. So I went ahead and did that this morning. I did a ton of leveling up of stuff and things. You can see Terry's now level 75. Let's see, how much XP to get to next level? 6,500. So I did a bunch of leveling on him. I got a bunch of narcotics made. I did a bunch of killing dinosaurs, and we got all the stuff and things that we need. So yeah, we set up a couple other things over here. Oh, wait, hold on, peeps. I want to tell you guys something. Tiny want to say thank you guys for all your support on the ARK videos. Thank you guys so much for all your support on the ARK videos. If you guys like the video, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. But all right. Oh, so buildable saddles, Bronto saddles, level 70s is where they are. Bronto platform. It's a platform saddle. 35 Engram points. Nailed it. Oh, yeah, we got it learned. Now, we also got a bunch of other stuff in here from getting up to 70. We got vaults and those sort of things. Now, heavy miner's helmet, you know, in the last season, never played around with this very much. We probably will this season. And all the other stuff you guys know, rocket launchers, the paint sprayer. And, you know, we have access to just about everything except some of this stuff up at the next level, which I do believe this is all the... I don't know what that guy is right there. That... I'm not sure. No, it's not the plesio saddle. I'm not sure what that guy is. This is the scuba gear stuff and things, I do believe. But all right, so now we can build the Bronto saddle. Let's us take a look again, actually, back down inside of Hyon and see. Needs to be crafted in the smithy. So let's head down to the smithy and take a look at what kind of materials we're going to need. But yeah, so really excited. Oh, yeah, thank you guys so much for, I think it was the first video of the season. We're at over 20,000 likes on it now, guys. Absolutely unbelievable. It's just, I can't, like, I just don't believe it. But all right, anywho, moving on. So we're going to need 550 hide, 325 fiber, 90 metal ingots, 125 silica pearls, and 45 cementing paste. This is not going to be cheap. We've got to get a lot of stuff and things. We don't have any silica pearls. Or I think I have a few up top. The 90 metal ingots, I don't believe we've got. We've only got one in here. We've got a lot of... Oh, there's a few. And then that's it. So we're going to have to get metal, all sorts of things, guys. Hide, fiber. So you know what? The hide and the fiber, those sorts of things. I think we can take a look right here on John Deere and see what we've got. So we got some hide. There we go. Nail the days that can't be stopped. Fiber, we've got some. I think that should be enough. Nail the days that can't be stopped. We got a little bit of metal right there. So we're doing pretty good. Cementing paste, we don't have any on us, but we've got plenty of chitin. I mean, the addition of the Meganurna and the Titan Monirna have made it so that it's so easy to get chitin. Guys, check this out. Is it, which chest is it? Yeah, right here. Full chest, full of the stuff and things that we need. And we already have a bunch of it in here as well. So, all right, I'm going to take a break, get the stuff and things together that we need to do the saddle, and then I will BRBs, peeps. And we're back. We got some hot cementing paste. Wait, that's not cementing paste. We got some hot cementing paste action, finally. And I went out and got all the other stuff and things that we need. Killed a bunch of trilobites. Got some silica pearls. Did some metal harvesting. Got all that stuff going. Then we got the cementing paste. We got a little bit extra. Let's squirt that in there. Here we go, peeps. Saddles. Let's build this bad boy. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Building a saddle. It's happening. It's hatting, as Zueljin will say. Zueljin always says, what's hatting? He doesn't say it to you guys, but he should. Shouldn't he start off his episodes like that? What's hatting? You know what? Everyone go over to Zueljin's channel right now and just type in his latest video. What's hatting? And see what he says. All right. So, all right. We got it. We got it. How much does it weigh? That's what I'm interested in. Only 20? That's so silly. I can't believe it only weighs 20. All right. So, we're not going to carry it. Should we carry it with us? I'm not sure. You know what? Let's go ahead and drop these berries. You're going on the ground, stupid ground berries. Let's grab this guy. Can you fly with a 20-pound saddle? You can. Now, the next portion of our day is going to be looking for a Bronto. Now, the elusive Brontosaurus is quite hard to discover. Not sure if you were aware of it. Also, you may notice stuff and things look a little different. Oh, I want to show you guys this. I changed some of my settings. So, I'm running epic, epic, high, 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 medium, medium now. And I turned squy quality? Squy quality and guau quality all the way down. But then I unchecked some stuff inside of here. So I only have the high quality materials, subsurface scattering, and a high quality VFX. And then I have mesh level detail all the way up. Those are basically the big changes that I made just to try to squeak out a little bit better frame rate. So, all right. But anyway, so now we've got to find the elusive Bronto. So let us go over here and see what we can see. You know, they're very difficult to find. They're not always, you know, in a place where you can just go to that place and there will always be Brontos there. It's more of a search. It's more of a process where you've got to search and find them. Found one. All right, let's take a look real quick. Let's see what we got over here. Level 4? That's not even a mouse on a wheel. What do we got over here? Wait, who are you? Level 16? I bet you there might be a couple more Brontos if we squirt up a little further over here. There's another one. Nailed it. There's, oh my god, it's a whole herd of the elusive Brontos. 8, 12, 12, 28. Oh my gosh, there's another one over there. What level are you, homie? Please be not awful. All right, 44. I feel like that's a good level. I feel like that's a decent level for us to do stuff and things. Let's take a look over here. Do we have any? That's a huge scorpion fight. You know what? Maybe we can drag him a little bit further away. So let's pop down over here. Hit a U. Pop a whistle passive. Grab one of these bad boys. And then let's see. Oh, Dilo action! No, don't squirt at me. Don't squirt me, Dilo. Don't squirt me, buddy. Alright. Alright, here we go. Come to me! Yeah, you peeved off now? You want some of this hot action, Bronto? Oh no! Stuff's attacking it! Oh, crap! I was afraid of this. I was so afraid of this. And we're back on the hunt for the elusive Alonosaurus, which is a Brontosaurus that is also alone. And we have found one! And he's an okay level. I mean, he's not like a bad level. He's 108. So this is going to be challenging. I only have 49 Trank Arrows. I honestly don't even know if that's going to be enough. Just make sure we're on passive. I don't think anything's around it. Let's do this! Did I not hit you? All the lag. Get knocked out, stupid Brontosaurus! Are you possibly stuck, please? No. Oh, crap. Oh, he's on the move! He is on the move! Can we get you stuck? Is that a possible thing that can happen, please? Oh, yeah! You stuck, stupid Brontosaurus. You can't come get me. Right in the face. Right in the face area, please. I'm going to shoot you right in your thinker. Right up in through your mouth hole. That's how we do it, peeps. I don't know if you know that the second most vulnerable place on a Brontosaurus after its buckloaca is the under... Oh, no, he's getting a little bit closer. Oh, no, he's lunging. Oh, no, you're fine. You're fine. Oh, you're just too... Oh, now crap. Oh, we're in deep trouble. It's a big problem. It's a big problem. Okay, now you're stuck again. No, this is great. Big problem resolved. Now he's not stuck. Big problem again. Run with your stupid crossbow. Oh, we can do this. Ninja. Ninja. You can't get over us. Haha. Suck it. You're stuck. Aren't you? Please be stuck. No, he's not stuck. He's not even a little bit stuck. Oh, he just smacked me right in the face. Zerp. Haha. In your butt. Now you're stuck. Enough arrows we have? Asked Yoda. Probably not, said Slipgator. Nope. That was a big mess problem. All right, here we go. Here we go. Oh, why do you keep... Stop. Just sitting in one spot, homie. All right, just like that. That's perfect. You're doing great. You're doing really, really good. And we're back with a much easier way to kite a Bronto, ladies and gentle peeps. I'm just sitting up here on top of the hill now. And got climbed up here. I got Terry hanging over there. I got a dead Dilo right over there. And I actually had to go back and make more arrows. I died. There was a bunch of debauchery, and I'm not actually sure if we're going to be able to tame this guy because he's taking a lot of damage. There was a T-Rex that came over, and I lured it away. It's been quite an adventure, but I'm hoping that we'll be able to get him down. I have a ton of narco arrows now, a huge amount. I had 130, I think, when I started again. So we shall see. Hopefully we can get this big boy down. And he's down, finally! OMGs, he's finally down! I can't believe it! Oh my gosh, we got him down. All right, so... are you going to attack my Mega Nora? Sweet. So you're good to go. All right, no problem. We got that one guy. We got this guy down. Any predators in the area? Feels safe. Looks safe. Unbelievable. Now, I don't have any berries or anything on me right now. Let's go ahead and just take a look at what we got going on over here. 4,400 hit points. How much Tobor did he have? Only 14,998. No big whoop there. So we got to go ahead and get a bunch of stuff and things. I don't know if we have anything back at the base that we can make kibble with. I'm not exactly sure, but I'm going to do that, and I will BRB's, peeps. And we're back. And there's a Dilo inside of here. All right, it finally came out. I thought it was going to be all over. Come here, stupid Dilo. So it didn't kill it. Oh my gosh, guys. I can't even believe it. That was super scary. I thought we were going to lose this Bronto to something dumb like that. And that happens, you know, c'est la ARK. C'est la vie, c'est la ARK. It just is the way it is. I haven't even gone away yet. I started to fly off and then I heard it and I came back. But yeah, all right. Need to find out if we have any turtle eggs for Bronto kibble. And we're back. And this guy lost a lot of taming effectiveness because of the stupid medjo berries. We didn't have any trike eggs. Turtle eggs. So there was no kibble to be had. And he lost a lot of taming effectiveness from getting attacked by that Dilo. But he's still 108 plus 38 levels. So he's still going to tame out at 146. So he's going to be pretty baller guy. Got Terry over here. Got a little hot food action going. Stuff and things are happening. I'm assuming. Oh, God. He's so close. You're so close. Become my guy. Become my guy and do your things. Become a guy. And then we put the saddle on you. If you become a guy, everything will be better. Become a guy! Now! Oh my gosh. One more berries. One more berries, probably. I'm guessing. We didn't have to use any narco on him at all. His narco goes down super duper slow. So we don't have to worry about that, even though I brought some over with me. Oh no. No! No! Oh god, tame! Tame, 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 tame! Tame now! Eat your food, stupid Bronto! Eat your food! Eat your food! Thank you! Mobility is a thing! I can't believe another Dilo started attacking it, man! Oh, so he only tamed out of 134, but it doesn't matter, guys, because we got him, and that's all that counts. He was super amazing, and now he's just slightly less amazing. But let's go ahead, first things first, let's squirt the mobile saddle on him. Come here, man. Let's see what you look like, yo. Come over here. Oh, baby! It's getting a little bit dark. Let me see here. Gamma 3? Oh, yeah, better. Check it out, peeps. We got a mobile saddle. You know what I want to find out? All right, we need to know some stuff and things about this. Can we land? Oh, crap. Oh, crap. We fell. Are you on here? Pterodon? Terry's on him. We're on it with you. You're here. We're on top of mobility. Drive. Oh, wait. Where are we now? Okay, we're on him. Let's go. Are you stuck, stupid Bronto? Best thing ever. Dude, we got a mobile base. Look, he's bouncing around. So the looks like the dinos don't really stay on all that well. Eventually, will he fall off? Look at him go. Look at him bouncing all around. It doesn't look like he is going to fall off. It looks like he just bounces. I wonder if you could put a Bronto on a Bronto. I mean, obviously, that would be a trick. You'd have to get one like on the edge of the cliff or something. Oh, man. All right. And so just for us to see here, what did he end up taming out at? No, wait, what? Wrong. So he's got 5,500 health, 580 stamina, O2 food, whatever, 1,260 weight, 322 melee damage. Not bad. All right, we're skidding back to base, peeps. One day. And we're back. And arduous journey is not the term I would use. If there's one that's worse than arduous journey, then that would be the term that I would use. We barely made it back alive, peeps. It was super, super difficult. I was getting attacked by everything. Oh, that's weird. Do you see the texture for that keeps going out? What's up with that? All right, now it's back. Is it a camera distance thing? Oh, let's see here. Let's test this. So camera distance closer, 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 closer. Oh, is that Terry? Oh, no, it's not. Hold on. Who are you? It's Spumwack. Spumwack came to hang out with us for a second. We lost Terry, by the way. He's gone somewhere. Spumwack, your bird is gone. Where's your bird, Spumwack? He's following us. But, yeah, Terry fell off the... and flew away, actually. It was really weird. I was attacking a Bronto. Like, something aggroed me. A bunch of stuff was going on. A Bronto was attacking. I was attacking it. It slashed his tail. It hit Terry. Terry was on, I do believe, passive. But Terry ran away. And he's gone now, so we'll have to go and check him out and look for him. But at the very least... oh, man, we're listing! At the very least now, we've got mobility back over here at our main base. We've got to try to find a flat spot. I don't know. We'll just leave him here, right, I guess, for now, maybes. Oh, my God. But the lag in this area is something else because of all the dinos here. But we're going to get some building materials together to do some fooling around on the back of this thing. And that will be our bees, peeps. And we're back, and I'm just working with some thatch... foundations, and I kind of found something kind of interesting to start off with. Check out this. I mean, look at that. It's basically not even on the saddle platform at all, which is really, really weird and strangely interesting that you can do that in a hugely diagonal fashion like that. Really neat. So that's just something to, yeah, anyway, so it's a thing. And then I'm trying to see if we were to place, like, for realsies, like, how many could we place? Like, I can't. It's so hard to place. Now, is that, like, as far back as it can go? No, it isn't. So then, if we were to do, like, another one, no, that would be this guy instead. Okay, so you could really not necessarily do three in a line unless you were really kind of good about it. So, all right, check this out. So what we're going to do, we're going to break this off. We're going to break this guy off. So let's take a look at the center of this. The center is kind of, like, right where this is. So it's a little bit off to the left of this line. So, like, this center area or these two lines here, they're not exactly, like... centered with the center of the platform, but you know, you get it. We're all on the same page. Let's do this. So now, if we were to come over here like a so, and then maybe go like that, and then maybe go like this, and then go like this. Okay, pretty close to the center. If you wanted to place, so it's roughly three foundations wide. Now, if we were to squirt down here, yeah, we're gonna hurt ourselves a lot. All right, so that's fine. We just hurt ourselves a lot. Let's go ahead and... oh, we have some stuff and things on us. Let's get some thatch roofs going. We can only make three of those because... fiber? I do believe. Squirt some more fiber in here. Like a so. One of these. Let's make nine. So we're going to craft a huge amount of these guys up. And what I want to kind of see here is... can we, like, go out on from the edge to in every direction so we can build the platform bigger, so to speak? Do you understand? Does that make sense? Let's go ahead and get up here. All right, so now if we were to replace this guy with these guys, and we were to place it out on the side here, are you going to snap on there? Nailed it. And then can we go in another one? I can't believe it. We can have wings! Our guy can have wings, man! This is amazing. Oh, wait, how come we can't do that one? Oh, that's weird. Okay, that doesn't really make any sense at all. Very interesting. Is there something possibly obstructing it that we can't see that's invisible? Requires nearby foundation support, which we have right there. Is it because the back legs aren't touching or something to that effect? Let me turn the gamma up a little bit here. It might be. That's really interesting. You know what I want to do? I want to see how big of a platform we can fit on here, and then I'll BRBs. And we're back. I'm just doing some testing here, peeps, and the laws of ARK physics don't seem to apply quite the same on these saddles. So normally if you have either a foundation or a ceiling that's supported by a pillar, you can build out two from it on any side. But you can't on a saddle platform for some reason. I can't build out two here. I've got another pillar right here. I can't build out two from it. I have another pillar right here. I have two pillars, as you can see, and I can't build out from it either. So, kind of interesting. Now, if I was to take another pillar right here and build that, yes, we can. No, we can't. So, it's really strange. Over here, I can go two out, but I can't go two out everywhere. My idea was kind of to see, you know, how fat of a platform I could make up on top of here so that I could get some things done. Now, let me see here. If we go like this, okay, we can do that. All the way out here, like so, and then that one shouldn't be able to, which makes perfect sense because there isn't actually a pillar that's within two from it. So if we place this like so, and then we come over here, we can. So you see some stuff and things are a little bit wacky here, peeps. So let's at least see how big we can go. And we're back, and this looks like about as big as we can go here, peeps. Let's go ahead and get a fly up here so we can get a better look at it. Let me see. That's pretty big. It's a pretty big platform. I'm not sure. There might be some way that you could build on it in a different way so that it would allow you to do it. I mean, I tried doing pillars for supports and the foundations for supports as well. And it comes out, it ends up coming out in a kind of a weird shape because we can go one further on the left side than we can on the right side. But that's a pretty big platform. Now, I hear tell that you can only put 50 things on any one of the saddles. So if we take a look at this, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 12, 6, 12, 18, 24, 36. Let me see here. That's 36, right? So, all right. Each one of these rows is 6. 6, 12, 18, 24, 30. I don't know where 36 came from. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, and then 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48. That's with the pillars and everything. So there's 48 things on here. So that means really all we need to do is put a couple more things on. 48, 49, 50, 51. Oh, that might be it. There are already too many structures on this platform. So yeah, it looks like 50. That is correct. It's the maximum amount of things that you can actually put on the platform at any one time. So you do have to be kind of careful as far as what it is that you want to place on top of your saddle platform. That's really interesting info. All right, so now that we've got kind of like some of the info, some of the technical stuff and things figured out, it's time to actually build something on here, peeps. And we're back. And I had what I thought was this really cool idea I wanted to show you guys, but it failed. But I'm going to tell you what's going on. So, in the last update, they changed it so that crop plots could now be placed on structures. As you can see here, we have a green crop plot on top of this foundation. And like around over here, it won't be able to place everywhere because the terrain's kind of wacky, but you could always just place them on regular terrain. So I thought, would it be cool? I asked Zueljin, he had found some plant species X seeds. I actually have them over here on Terry. And I asked him if I could borrow four of them, just real quick while I wanted to try this out. And what I thought we would do is build these, like, angled platforms. And then down over here, we'd have the plant species X turrets on top of the saddle and on the platform. And it'd be the most amazing thing ever. You can't do it. Look what happens. This structure cannot be placed on a platform. So you can't place these on a platform. And I don't think, I mean, I'm going to take a wild guess. I actually didn't test this out yet. But I'm going to say you can't place these on the platform at all. That really stinks, man. No mobile farming. I mean, you know what? I mean, it's too bad. I gotta be like, it's a detractor. Don't get me wrong, ARK devs. What you've done with the platforms is absolutely unbelievable. But my idea was super awesome and I was really excited about it, but we can't do it. You can see we just get the spinny crop plot platform. So we can't place these here. All right, so that was my idea. I'm just gonna demolish the whole thing. Goodbye, idea. Oh, wait, what? How is this sorcery? What is happening? You shouldn't be able to be a thing. You're just a floating thing. Hold on. If we move. Oh, holy glitch, peeps. So that's a humongous glitch. Is it just because this thing is kind of still attached? If we take this off. All right, there we go. It was just that one pillar. So anyway, my idea has been foiled. It's okay. We'll do something else. And we're back in our mobile base. This is the thing, peeps. We've done some stuff and things, guys. I gotta show you this. Let me see. First of all, can we land on top of the base? I haven't even tried this yet. Can you land up here, yo? No, kind of not. Will you land? No, it wants to go a different way. No, not here. I want you to land on the top. I want this to be epic. Oh, yes. Don't move. Oh, no, we died. All right. So we could just respawn right at Poop City. We'll just start right back where we were. It's no problem. We had a little bit of a problem there. A little bit of fall damage. All right, and we're back. All right, so let's go back and get our stuff here really quickly. Come on. Fall down. You're doing it. This is amazing. Here we go. And we're out. And we're heading over to the mobile base. Mobility. All right, there we go. So I'm really kind of still, I was working on this for a while now, and still kind of bummed that we couldn't get the turret thing to work. I wanted that. I mean, we could put regular turrets, but I really wanted it to work with the Plant Species X turrets, but oh wells. All right, we'll take all this from inventory. Nailed the days to can't be stopped. Got all of our stuff back. And we will do one of these like this, like so. Bam, 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 bam. All right, here we go. Let's climb up, and we'll get on. And I'll show you what we've got. A couple more puzzles over here. We got a couple campfires here. We got three storage boxes there. We've got a couple of refining forges and a smithy, Pete. That's right. Now, this ladder I did here is I face it, so you have to go backwards in order to get up it. Now, if you fall off, interesting. Fun fact, you just hit your F key, or E key, pardon me, remount, and then you can come back through. So super easy. And then this way, when we go up, we can walk this way straight off. Because I tried to do the fences to make a railing around here, and I couldn't get them to stack higher than like 6 high. Remember, the arc laws of structural physics don't really work the same here. So for some reason, I don't know why, on this upper ceiling, when I tried to do it, I could place 5 or 6, or I think it was maybe 6 or 7, and then I couldn't place any more. So we do have Terry up here. No, that's cool. Just crapping our new mobile base, Terry. Stupid. Anyway, and we have a bed as well. So let's go ahead and rename the bed. Mobility bed. So that we know where it is. So we can spawn up here if we want to. But yeah, so this is our mobile base. It's just the beginnings. I just kind of wanted to try it out. Now, I think, if I'm not mistaken, Draax and Mazion have built one too. And they did like a big ladder thing all the way down, which is a super cool idea. I really like it. And I didn't do that because I wanted to save on the number of items. I'm not really sure how many items I have on here right now. 3, 6, 9, 10, I think 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 4, 35, 36, 37, 38 items, I think. So I've only got like 12 more items that I could place on here. So we could do the ladder thing, but I didn't think that we would do it right now. The other thing that I did is I went ahead and put some spark powder in these torches on the corners. All right, like so, like so. All right, let's get it all lit up. Let's head up to the top. Oh, I think Terry is making it so we can't get up. Hold on, hold on. Oh, nailed it. Let's get these guys going. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Terry, you're in the way. We're going to have to fly you down for nowsies. And then squirt back up. Nailed it. Back over here. One of these. 360. Up on top. Nailed it. Oh, yeah. All right. Now, the big problem is you have to be really careful. If I fall off of here all the way down to the bottom, I'm almost always going to die. If we go like that, we're good to go. We took a little bit of damage there, like so. But if we fly up, let's fly around over here and then come in and take a look. See what she looks like. Oh, baby. So baller. That's so cool, man. I love it with the torches. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, make sure you smash the thumbs up button to show your support for stuff and things. We gotta drive it like this, man. You know, when we did the rafts the other day with Zueljin, when we had the campfires on, it made this like super crazy fire action happen when we were doing the campfires around. Oh, so we don't get the crazy fire, but still, it looks amazing. Could you imagine? Oh God, in the future, like when we get into metal and we can have turrets on it and stuff like that, it's gonna be so crazy. Let's come out here a little bit. Oh my God, this is so amazing. Could you imagine? Could you even get this in Survival of the Fittest? I mean, I guess you could. You could never get to the turret level. But on a PvP server, the turrets would just be unbelievable. All right, hold on. We got to check something really quickly. If we put... Give me some of this. If we put fire in these guys, does the fire do its special thing? Does it do the, like, super big fire? Because I want to see if that's the case. Like it does it on the raft. Oh, yeah, it kind of does. I love that it's, like, on fire. Oh, man, we need to have, like... Oh, it'd be so cool to have, like, two of the mobile bases with, like, turrets on them and stuff, and then have it, like, people, like, fighting, and, like, you'd have a battle. I couldn't even imagine how cool that would be. Oh, I'm so psyched about it, guys. I think this is such a cool addition to the game. Oh, amazing. Amazing! Let's get a little bit better aim. Head back over to this early direction. Squirt over here like this. Oh, my God. Love it. Love it. Love it so much. There's my dead body down there. All right, guys, this is so cool. I'm really excited that this is a thing, and it was so fun to play around with it today. I can't wait to